This is Funaki, SmackDown number one announcer. And I'm here to get ready with John Cena, who tonight goes one on one with Rikishi.
I'm John C. My style's smooth, never choppy. Number one announcer is me, it ain't Funaki. So Keish wants to release pieces of his feces, but when the match is over, he tastes my cheeks cheeses. Stop, repeat this, I win, I never lose. Every single match, I got a new pair of shoes, which I can use as toys or decoys. How am I gonna lose to a lost member of the Fat Boys? Word life. Yup.
It's pretty tight. So you wanna freestyle, huh? Yo, check it.
John Cena, you wanna bust a rhyme on me? You better make like a tree and leave this place, know this state. Beat down, no, this is SmackDown. Every time I come around, I put the mash down. The WWE is mine. Anybody get in my way, it's Rikishi time. So this ain't the time, this ain't the place. Get a piece of the quiche right in your face. Word to your mother.
And John Cena heading to the top rope. And Rikishi is in trouble in the center of the ring. High risk maneuver for the rookie John Cena.
She's gonna fly, baby. Here he goes.
Oh, and a missile drop kick to the sternum. The cover. Cena with a big upset. And Rikishi gets the shoulder up. Will Eddie Guerrero be able to pull off the big upset later tonight against Brock Lesnar?
Hey, man, I know Eddie Guerrero a long time. I'm a big fan of Latino heat. He don't sweat nobody, but notice how he said, we. I guess he's got a mouse in his pocket.
Chavo, Guerrero.
Yeah, him and Chavo, I guess. You got to face Brock Lesnar, especially in a time like this, where Big Show has been putting Lesnar through and the stuff Heyman has been saying to Brock Lesnar.
Bit of a Samoan drop. John Cena felt that, and Rikishi is beginning to feel it himself.
The Big Keith's going to back it up,
Rikishi backing it up to John Cena.
Thump from hell. Here it comes, Cole. Thump from hell.
Rikishi make good on his promise from a bit ago.
Once the thump happens, the stink starts a coming. Oh, man. Oh, no. Well, John Cena's good looks became stinky and rugged.
And John Cena not too pleased that he was the recipient of the stink face.
He's not a happy stinky face, man.
And he walked right into that. Rikishi with authority.
Oh, man, Cena's in place. Call for a rope shaker. Look at the size of that bad boy.
Rikishi, 150 pounds into the chest. Up over the top, Rikishi. Oh, Cena just saw his life flash before his eyes.
The dark side of his life.
And Cena.
And the stinky side.
This.
Cena can
trying to imitate Rikishi. And here's the cover. Rikishi kicked out with authority.
Well, I mean, Cena ain't got the size ass that Rikishi has. Why would he try that? I don't get it.
I guess imitation, flattery.
You want a piece of me? You want to throw me out like that? Come on, baby.
Cena,
come on.
What's wrong with this?
This is Cena's house, Cole Hoffman.
Just got knocked out of his house.
Shot under the chin by Rikishi, and John Cena whipped across the ring. Samoan drop.
Come on, JC.
Plants John Cena, and Rikishi about to back it all up.
350 pounds on the hop.
Man. And John Cena planted off the belly to belly. Hook of the leg. It's over. Rikishi defeats John Cena. And Rikishi's taking it out on B squared and John Cena, these soft losers. And look at Cena. Oh, and Latav trying to do the right thing. But a cheap shot for it. This double team on Rikishi by Cena and B squared. Oh, no. Oh, what a shot. A shot to Cena. The task mission. The task mission. John Cena. Has just
Rikishi.
That's a bling bling for you.
Yeah, I was telling you, Rikishi loves to have fun. He likes to take every day as it comes along and have fun doing it. But when he's in the ring, he's all business.
Yeah, he's a tough dude to beat. Rikishi's but beat too. Oh, let's not sell him short.
Rikishi, 350 pounds, knocking B2 down, and follows it up with a big clothesline on a night where he saw it. Oh, look out! And B2 into a big back body drop. Saw Stephanie McMahon, the general manager of SmackDown, back in the locker room area earlier on, and she is so excited. And how can you blame her? Big Papa Pump is signing with SmackDown here tonight.
No doubt, can't wait. Big two for SmackDown.
And B2 with a big right hand to the side of the head of Rikishi. And this B2 is a solid athlete. Throw away the rapping and the hip-hopping and the fun. B2 is all business as he's going to work here on Rikishi. Also here tonight, Edge and Angle, as you mentioned earlier, a unique in the athleticism of B2. B2 missing the clothesline. Samoa drop by Rikishi.
Check this out. Bottom's going to fall out on B2.
Oh, and John Cena, realizing his buddy was in trouble, the distraction, and he pays for it. And John Cena into the ring.
Oh, Tony Gwynn don't fly like that.
Oh, and a right hand by Rikishi. Oh! Someone kicked to B2, and Rikishi's cruising.
Here we go.
That'll suck the wind out of you.
Uh-oh. Oh, man.
Rikishi raising the roof.
And Cena.
And a low blow by B2. The referee never saw it. Cordero was busy with John Cena.
Look at that.
What the hell is this?
B2's got
his head. That chain that was around his neck right into the head of Rikishi. B2. Into the cover, B2 steals one. Rikishi wasted little time going to work on John Cena. And, well, you know what John Cena said about the Guerreros last week? Their little altercation in the back as well.
Pretty funny stuff, but right now this ain't funny because Rikishi is looking to lay the smackdown, no pun, on Cena.
Well, Rikishi's one of those guys at 350 pounds who loves to have fun, but for Rikishi, it's all about business tonight. John Cena has not liked Rikishi ever since Rikishi beat him at his own game in the hip-hop challenge a couple of weeks ago.
Well, that's going to affect John Cena's rapping ability.
That will as well. Rikishi and John Cena kicking us off here tonight on what is a night of mayhem and marriage. The wedding of Al Wilson and Dawn Marie here in the land of enchantment, New Mexico. How about the return of Brock Lesnar?
Yeah, speaking of, I can't wait for the mayhem. And that is Mr. Lesnar, Brock Lesnar.
350 pounds onto the chest of Cena. Cover, hooks the leg. And Rikishi with the left hand, and there's the right to John Cena.
Well, Rikishi's a heavy hitter.
Look out, Rikishi.
Backing that big bum up. Bum means like butt, get it?
What the hell is look at B2's got that damn chain in his hand. What the hell is he doing?
I guess he wants to interfere in the match, Cole.
Get out like a twister.
Get referee spots him.
Good thing he did. Oh, look out. Going for the ride. Rikishi planting John Cena. The cover, but the referee's busy with B2.
There's the ref, he sees it.
And Cena pops out, only got a count of one there. I think Rikishi may have picked up a victory.
Oh, you can't knock the ref. The ref's got his hands full out here with B2. And, well, here comes B2.
B2 brought in the hard way.
Brought in the hard way, all right. And now he's going to get something else the hard way.
Referee trying to break up B2 and Rikishi. Cena just shoved the referee out of the way.
Well, he can't cause a disqualification because B2 was brought in the ring by Rikishi.
Good point.
Thank you.
Oh, look at John Cena. Roman Rikishi up. John Cena, he got him. John Cena wasted a little time. The quick attack on the 350-pound Rikishi. And here Cena goes to work in this matchup.
You got to figure John Cena's looking at Rikishi and visualizing that's Brock Lesnar.
Well, John Cena promised to call out Brock Lesnar here tonight. And Cena taking out his frustrations with his vicious assault on Rikishi.
Referee's trying to calm down Cena, but here comes Rikishi's with those big haymakers.
The big right hands to John Cena. And an arm will knock Cena completely out of the ring.
We're going to see the land on his knee or waddle. What happened out there?
John Cena struggling to his feet. Perhaps John Cena started off this matchup a little too quickly. And Rikishi is taking advantage there.
Well, Rikishi's a veteran. He'll let you go out there and expose yourself.
Into the steel stairs.
Nice. Nice reversal by John Cena, thinking right there. Taking out the 350-pounder with the steel steps.
Cena wisely back into the ring to break the 10 count. John Cena wants to send a message here tonight to Mr. Lesnar as he tears that protective padding off the barricade.
Might get himself disqualified.
Driving the kidneys into that exposed steel that surrounds the ring.
Yeah, that's just the thin padding around there.
And again, Cena back in to break up the referee's 10 count. Rikishi trying to bow back, but driven in again. Look, the anguish in the eyes of Rikishi.
Rikishi's a very big, strong man, a tough, tough man, big for a lot. And John Cena's putting Rikishi through some pain.
John Cena rolling Rikishi into the cup. Hooks the leg. Rikishi kicks out. It's rump shaking time for Rikishi.
Bottom's gonna fall out. Cena, watch out.
And Cena counter.
Oh, man, low.
Knees low. Hopefully knocked out as well. John Cena's got that chain wrapped around his hand. John Cena stalking Rikishi.
Rikishi's gonna get a face full of chain.
Steel chain in hand.
Heads up, out down.
Steel chain to the forehead of Rikishi. The cover, hook of the leg. And Rikishi fouled out. Now, the hell did he do that?
He pointed out, man, how tough Rikishi is.
John Cena cannot believe it.
Believe me, when Rikishi's back, and then the first time he hit the face with the chain.
Get up!
Cena just begging Rikishi to get to his feet.
Man, this is, I'll tell you, this scene has picked up the intensity level, though, in his in-ring style since he's been out of the ring, I'll tell you that.
He really has. John Cena. Just stalking Rikishi.
Go to get him, go to get him.
Yeah, that's 350 pounds. That's 350 pounds.
Is this going to be, he's in position for an F5.
John Cena driving Rikishi to the mat.
Death Valley.
Blackboard's still in the ring. Hold on here, guys. Wait a minute.
Cena and Umaga are not waiting for the referee.
Look at this.
Bill with a Billy suplex.
Somebody send a referee down here.
And Cena grabbing Umaga now.
Yeah, referee.
Face first. And Cena now assaulting Umaga. And no one has manhandled Umaga like John Cena currently is, since Umaga has debuted in the WWE.
I don't think I've seen the look of pain on Umaga's face. Oh no! Good God! God! Have we seen Umaga do this before?
350 pounds!
Look out! There's nobody home!
Umaga looking to destroy Cena, but nobody there! And Cena now, reaching down! John Cena with high impact. Cena looking to become the first man to beat Umaga.
The kick.
And the strength of John Cena. That's a 350 pounder at least.
Wait a minute. Look at John Cena. Umaga. Like him or love him, you got to admit this guy's strong. And Umaga, you can't see him. But you can't feel the fat knuckle shuffle.
Cena sticking that big right hand into the face of Umaga.
Estrada's trying to get the ring.
Get him down. Get him.
Oh, there's edge. Watch the spike.
No. Go. The kick to the face, and then the Samoan spike on Cena. Umaga will. Umaga beats Cena.
Well, it's not a good idea, even for John Cena, to try and slug it out. I don't know how he can slug it out with Umaga. It's clear that Umaga may be even stronger than that man right there, the WWE champion.
And that Samoan drop may be it, John Cena. The air rushing out of his body. Cena will fight you as long as he's breathing. That's the Cena style. Unrefined smash mouth, ground and pound, and a blockbuster takedown by John Cena, much to the delight of the this sellout crowd capacity and more. And Cena now using the ropes for additional leverage. He has the big man teetering. Umaga has yet to go down. Cena 3-point, leaves his feet, and Umaga still, oh my God.
He's caught the ropes.
Umaga tied up with the ropes. And John Cena taking advantage of the opportunity. John Cena right hand, left hand, and Estrada better get himself down.
Well, like any good manager, Armando trying to distract the champion, and it worked, but I don't know if it worked the way he wanted to go.
What the hell? The Big Show, the world's largest athlete, the ECW champion. This is not Tuesday night. This is Monday Night Raw, and look at this.
It's two giants teaming up on the champ. There's no way he can get out of this with a happy ending.
Umaga, that spike right to the throat of Cena. Down went Cena. What the hell is the Big Show doing here tonight? Estrada directing traffic. In the meantime, the WWE Champion John Cena is getting physically dissected by two of the biggest men ever in the WWE.
Well, it's obvious the Big Show can't wait until Survivor Series to get his hands on John Cena. He wanted him here tonight, and boy, is he getting him.
Cena is a sitting duck here. There's three men in the ring. Cena's got... Oh, look out, look out, look out.
Oh, my!
Umaga moving at 360 at least, and now the Big Show. That's 507 pounds, ladies and gentlemen. 507 pounds. Oh, a big splash right down the heart, the chest, the lungs of Cena. Getting pummeled, and now look at the giant hand.
Look out!
Chopped down! God! My God! What a chokeslam! John Cena is getting broken in half by Captain Big Show.
I mean, can Cena even make it to Survivor Series?
Oh, no,
this
not
may
this.
Be the end
no.
of Cena right
no,
now.
Damn it, don't do this.
Here comes the spike.
This is not, oh, God almighty, the Samoan spike.
What the hell? My God, King, it's after the Master of Challenge, there's Umaga. The man that has challenged John Cena for the WWE title.
Well, we got challenges left and right tonight. Here we go.
And here they go. Cena and Umaga. This is not a match, but it's damn sure a fight.
Well, John Cena came out here earlier and challenged Umaga to get it on tonight. They're getting it on.
At the Pier 6 Brawl here in Charleston. And the undefeated Umaga. They're up nearly 400 pounds.
All the referees in the ring asking for more help. I don't think I'd want to get in between these two. Do you?
We've got some Marines here. There's security. The security trying to...
Talking about 10 guys to pull Umaga.
The security trying to break these guys up. And restraining Umaga and Cena.
Oh, look at
cheap shot. Damn, Estrada with a cheap shot on Cena.
Oh, here comes Umaga again.
And Umaga like a runaway
jet. Right out here in front of us. This is not going to be good. Look out, look out.
Other.
Yeah, I'm counting about five security guards. that everyone looked like unconscious out here.
As Tyler's trying to get Umaga out of here, Umaga's done damage to security guards.
All right. Man's ready to get down to business.
Well, let's get the fight in. Let's start the fight here.
Wait a minute. Is Kevin Federline asking for a test of strength?
Federline has got to be smarter than to want to test of strength with John Cena.
Apparently he's not. I mean, Kevin Federline trying to, look, he took John Cena down. Oh, and look at this.
Federline with a cross arm breaker, and I think Cena, is Cena just simply toying with Federline here? Is that what we're seeing?
Oh my God.
Look at the strength of John Cena.
Oh my.
Look at the strength of the WWE champion.
That's gotta be embarrassing to Kevin Federline. Oh, wait a minute.
And Nitro.
Johnny Nitro in the ring, and one, no, Johnny Nitro out of the ring.
Federline's coach just got ejected from the ring.
Watch your back.
Oh, a low blow. Federline with a low blow on John Cena.
From behind.
And
now Kevin Federline gonna put a little bad mouth. No, wait a minute.
Cena gonna take care of some business here early.
Look out.
Oh my God, Umaga. Umaga. Assaulting Cena, and remember, it's no disqualification here. Umaga is brutalizing a WWE champion.
And look at Estrada in the ring with John Cena's championship belt.
Umaga out of nowhere with his handler, Estrada.
What is Estrada instructing Umaga to do here? Wait a minute.
Oh, come on.
No.
Umaga with that WWE Championship belt hit John Cena right in the face with it.
And I think John Cena is out like a light.
Cena is motionless at the hands of this Samoan bulldozer who just hit Cena right in the face with Cena's own WWE Championship belt. This match continues because, remember, it was made no disqualification.
Well, Cena tried his best to block that.
Wait a minute. Look, Federline.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
No, come on. No, you gotta be kidding me.
Cena sticking and moving here. And Umaga, not as refined as some of the challengers that have come after the WWE title. And Cena trying to go power for power with Umaga. And starting off there.
Look out here.
And quick pace. Umaga right out.
Oh my God.
Wow. That's a big shot. That's scary. Umaga's scary. Umaga trying to hang on. Umaga scores that shoulder block, and Cena. Oh, God.
Oh my.
Umaga's head hit the ring post. I don't care how. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. My God. Cena with a suplex.
But our fans.
My God, the adrenaline rush.
That's right. They're saying, you can't see me.
This huge crowd at Kemper.
Shuffle, JR!
Whoa! Coming to their feet, this huge crowd here in Kansas City, and Cena's using that emotion and that adrenaline.
And look at Estrada, he is beside himself. He's in a panic mode right now.
Estrada sees a look on. Umaga's never been beat.
Well, Umaga obviously still has more strength left than John Cena does. Now what, JR?
Cena hung upside down in the proverbial tree of woe.
And Rubio,
take him out. No!
Yeah!
Umaga flying headbutt! Man, Cena was just a piece of raw meat, like hanging from a tree. And Umaga assaulted Cena, who was upside down with that flying headbutt.
Oh, no.
Can you imagine seeing something like that coming at you when you're hanging upside down?
Well, I can only imagine what we're seeing now, JR. We may be seeing end of the title reign of John Cena.
Umaga sticks this move. Say goodbye. Oh! Cena pulls himself up. Yes! Cena with a roll up. I have no idea. Estrada with a...
He's got a chair! He's
up on the apron of the folding chair. And, oh, John Cena!
Look out!
Using the folding chair on Khali. The referee calls for the bell. Khali didn't battle on. The great Khali got smacked with a steel chair by the WWE champion and did not bat an eye.
Oh, this is scary, JR. This is not boding well.
John Cena, my God!
Wait a minute, what's the story?
Now, Cena been decimated, and now Armando Estrada still.
Wait a minute, what's he doing?
What the hell is Estrada motioning to? Some fan in the crowd? Oh my God! It's Umaga! Postman said he gave Umaga the night off!
Oh Lord, son! Look at this now!
Umaga here to pick the balls! The man who's on the finish streak ended 24 hours ago.
Oh, my God.
Umaga with one loss on his entire record. And that was last night. But Cena now is helpless.
This is what Umaga tried to do last night, but it didn't work out tonight. Oh, my God. He hit it.
Cena ran down. And then, oh, my God, John Cena's face. John Cena's eyes, his face. Cena may be in trauma or in some shock of some sort.
Come on, that's enough. Oh, no, that's the long spike. Look out.
The spike to the carotid artery. Right in the throat. And another hand taking down Cena. The great Khali has cleared the ring of every breathing soul in it. And we may be looking at the winner of this Sunday's Royal Rumble. Khali had done. And look at Cena now. Tell the coach, you want some, come get some. What the hell is Umaga? Umaga! The number one contender for the WWE title. Umaga now. Good God, this is another scare. A swinging sidewalk slam from the number one contender for the WWE title now.
Coachman
and Estrada putting a table into the ring, and you can bet they're not going to set the table enough.
Not that spot
at the spike. Cena got the Samoan spike buried running deep into his throat from the near 400-pound number one contender.
Oh, wait a minute, Jerry. What the hell is this? What are they going to do?
Estrada got a smile on his face. What the hell is Cena incapacitated after receiving that Samoan spike?
Look at Estrada giving directions to Umaga.
No, you don't. Come on, King. You don't.
Hey,
this is a 400-pound man. This Umaga is a 400-pound man.
And look at Coachman holding on to Cena's head. Estrada's got
God, don't do this. Umaga at the top.
Yes!
Defenseless John Cena.
Umaga hits this. This may not just end the match. This may hit John Cena.
This 400-pound man.
Yeah. Oh. Nobody home. Thank goodness.
Well, Cena just saved his WWE title at least for a moment. It's about
again.
How Cena. Oh. Big break for Cena. Can he capitalize?
Yeah.
Umaga's face melting. And this Cena,
got
the spirit of a warrior, I'll tell you. Cena holding on to all his double look.
And the referee's counting both Cena and Umaga.
And that's exactly what the referee should do.
Well, Cena's up, Cena's up!
Cena's up! Somehow John Cena is up!
And he's telling Umaga, you can't see me! Five knuckle shuffle! Oh!
Big right hand by Cena, right into the face of the number one contender for the WWE title.
Oh, wait a minute. You gotta be kidding me. Look at John Cena!
How is Cena? Oh! Cena's head, I think, hit the steps. I know Umaga hit the steps, but Cena's body, I think, gave away on him. But Cena did block the Samoan spike, at least on that occasion.
Well, all that did, I'm afraid, was buy John a little more time.
And Cena being tied upside down. Cena upside down.
Look out here, Jared. Look out. Whoa, look at Cena! How did he do that?
Just the will to remain the WWE champion is all I can surmise.
What's he gonna do now?
Cena with a leg drop. John Cena with a leg drop that connected with Umaga.
And even that leg drop from the top rope was enough to keep Umaga down.
Good Lord. Cena running, hell bent right into the great Khali in that massive clothesline. Up. Where's Umaga going?
Where's Umaga going?
Hard elbows. John Cena has been hit with nothing but heavy impact and artillery. Umaga is a rudderless ship. And what a kick for that size 18 4E wrestling boot. John Cena hit right between the eyes.
We talked about, you know, when you look at this giant Khali, realize,
the impact. Cena's body thrown right into the steel steps with a thunderous. And Cena, look at John's face here. Cena's
keeping an eye on Umaga.
My God, Umaga's got the step.
Oh,
Umaga, the ring steps.
John, look out!
Oh, no, no!
Look out!
Kicks out with the WWE Championship on the line in this triple threat match.
Cena went to war last night with the great Khali, the largest man in the WWE, and survived.
And that was falls count anywhere. Cena Khali battled on the concrete, around the steel, on a crane, and look at that.
But I don't know about tonight, do you, JR?
No, absolutely not. John Cena now, this is not typical Cena. Cena, his knees up.
Uh-oh.
And Cena protected himself, got his knees up.
Every man can relate to what that feels like.
And now, boxing the strength of Umaga, catching Cena.
Look out!
Sidewalk slam. Suplex by John Cena.
Honestly, Caden Murdoch, you know, they've been...
Good Lord, look out, look out, look out! The sidewalk slam! The sidewalk slam by Umaga. Caden Murdoch was stalking Candace. There was no tag. Candace is just trying to get away from Caden Murdoch. Absolutely heinous. Wait a minute. Jeff Hardy. Downtown. Jeff Hardy going downtown with a steel chair.
And Candace Michelle.
Cena, who starts off with good right hands, but Umaga sets low.
And Umaga, on any given night, ordinarily is as dangerous a human being as you can be in the ring against, but tonight, Orton and Carlito have pumped Umaga up. Oh, he's off the charts, JR.
No doubt about that, that Carlito and Randy Orton, the number one contender to John Cena's WWE title, an opportunity that Orton will get at SummerSlam in 3 weeks, the biggest party of the summer. But you gotta wonder what's gonna be left of John Cena if Umaga continues this offensive onslaught.
Boy, Umaga literally trying to drive John Cena right through those turnbuckles.
King, let's not forget that Umaga is the Intercontinental Champion and a dangerous man, and that headbutt takes Cena down. Umaga, a big, athletic, super heavyweight, as we have documented. Oh, hard shoulder block. This is a superb athlete, this Umaga, the Samoan bulldozer. He's strong, he's thick, he's quick, and he has got a nasty disposition.
Oh, yeah. Great. That's the old expression, running into a brick wall.
And certainly Umaga poses a different threat than does Randy Orton, who is the number one contender. Orton is so dangerous in so many ways. Orton has seen that SummerSlam.
And look at this!
And Cena with that blockbuster. Look at Umaga! Umaga's up! And the athletic Umaga! And Cena, oh my God! Strength!
No!
Cena couldn't hold the 350-pounder. Hey, that ride to the announce table and the punishment has taken its toll.
And look at that.
On John Cena.
That just may have crushed Cena's skull.
And King, think 3 weeks away, SummerSlam, the biggest party of the summer. Cena versus Orton for the WWE title. And Cena cannot afford an injury this close to the SummerSlam. He just can't.
I want to tell you something. Listen, remember, last week, Cena suffered defeat at the hands of Carlito, but like you said, with a big assist from Randy Orton, but man, tonight.
And that's not taking anything away from Carlito, who's an extremely, extremely talented individual. There was some collusion there, and a resourceful, perhaps out of desperation move.
Cena trying to get some momentum here.
John Cena on top. Oh my God, Cena caught him in there. John Cena, no stranger to Umaga, trying to gain an early advantage because Cena knows that in a street fight against this agile super heavyweight, this will not be a pleasant time in Salt Lake City.
John Cena trying to get an early advantage. Umaga cut him right off.
Cena showing great strength, but couldn't execute the body slam. At least that's what I think Cena was going to go for. Again, Umaga with all that mass and power.
Boy, not a good idea there by John to try to lift that massive bulldozer there this early on in the match. Look out here! Wait a minute. No, wait, don't look out! No!
Oh, Umaga looking to do serious damage. Cena dodged the bullet there. And now Cena with that amazing strength and his will to fight is back in the hunt.
Well, Umaga had intended to bulldoze John Cena with that move we've seen so often in the corner, but get it against the ring post. Look out!
Again, no disqualification in this street fight. And the number one contender for the WWE title.
Whoa!
Oh, Cena.
Oh!
It's a street fight, but no disqualifications. Cena reaching for the steel weapon.
Here we go! Cena with that chair. Here he comes!
Oh! Cena taking down the huge Samoan bulldozer. Can Cena capitalize here? High wrist by Cena with power. That scores.
Does he have the strength? No!
And an injury by Cena to toss his title aspirations aside.
Whoa!
And now Cena! Cena's got him on up!
Yeah!
The power! Electrifying power!
Oh!
And John Cena prevails!
Ladies and gentlemen, Vintage Rock with a people's elbow. And there goes the champ. And here comes Cena. John Cena with Rock on top. John Cena. Now a two.
What they want.
Wow, the WWE title match is going to continue. Cena got a reprieve.
There'll be no countouts.
No disqualifications either. And Cena looking for that attitude adjustment.
We've both said the time for talk is over. You are the people's champ. Listen to the people. Hear it. Hear it, feel it, see it. There are people standing in the ceiling, not because they want us to talk, because they want a match. And not just a match. These people know what match. A match where generations collide. Only in the WWE would you be able to see Muhammad Ali and Mike Tyson in their prime. Only in the WWE would you be able to see Michael Jordan go one-on-one with LeBron James. The match that they want is John Cena versus The Rock. It's obvious this is what we should do. So do you want to talk about it? Or do you want to bring it?
John Cena, you have no idea what you just asked for. You asked The Rock to bring it. Oh yeah, The Rock will bring it. You bet your candy ass The Rock will bring it. But The Rock says we make history. The Rock says we do something that's never been done before. The Rock says we make the biggest matchup of all time. On the grandest stage in the world. WrestleMania 28, John Cena versus The Rock. But it's not just any matchup. No, not just any matchup. No. It's gonna be The Rock, the people's champ. Never alone. Team, bring it all day, all night long with the millions of The Rock's fans. WrestleMania 28, the main event. John Cena, the people's champion. The people's WrestleMania. If you smell what The Rock is cooking.
and The Rock just rubbing it in Cena's face. They did something I didn't think they'd do. They stayed on the same page. They stayed cohesive, and they won. I didn't think they could coexist.
Yeah,
they did here on this night.
Well, what's going to happen when the next chapter of this rivalry is written?
Chicken. Only The Rock could refer to me as Kung Pao Chicken. It's genius. It's absolutely brilliant because every single Chinese restaurant you go to, it's always there. It's perfect, Rock. And this is perfect Rock. The Rock comes out, does his shtick, holds the millions in the palm of his hand like only The Rock can do. But I must admit, I didn't come out here to swing from the people's strudel or whatever you're calling your people nowadays. I came out here to tell you you were right. You're right, I am that guy. I'm the guy who runs you down when you're not here. But as usual, just like everything else, you're only half right. Because I'm the guy that runs you down when you are here. You see, these people love The Rock. I was one of these people. Until I got to meet Dwayne Johnson. Dwayne Johnson is a self-centered, egotistical, see-through son of a... that wouldn't give a rat's ass if this company closed its doors tomorrow. Now, I'll tell you something, Jack. I don't need words like respect and loyalty to trend worldwide. Just like I don't need my notes for my promo on my wrist. Nice tattoo. So here's the skinny. April 1st, when the millions see John Cena versus The Rock, John Cena is gonna be eyeing up Dwayne Johnson. And I don't like Dwayne Johnson. You probably make your boobs bounce. There'll be a thing on your eyebrow that looks like the people's eyebrow. But I'm gonna be looking into the eyes of Dwayne Johnson and see a man afraid. Because you're gonna be looking at a dude who may not have balls, but a dude who is gonna beat the hell out of you at WrestleMania, Jack.
I said I was gonna come in here. I was gonna look you in the eye. I was gonna tell the world what I see. Fear. Fear that I'm taking everything away. Fear that everything you've worked hard for the last 10 years, when I beat your ass at WrestleMania, it all goes away. I see the fear in your eyes, John. The Rock hears the fear and doubt in your words. I see right through you. You think that you shook The Rock's confidence. The Rock has never, ever, ever been more confident about anything in his life. You understand something about me, John. Understand this. You strip away WrestleMania. You strip away the glitz, the glamour, the lights. You strip away Hollywood, the movies, the fame. You strip away the catchphrases. You strip away trending worldwide. You strip it all away. Look at me. You strip it all away.
If we do,
The Rock's core.
What do you
at
got?
The Rock's core.
We strip it away. What
the
do you got?
The Rock is 6'4", 260 pounds, a man that will rip your throat out. At your core, you will always be a little boy who will go down in history always as the Rock's.
The past year, we've said a lot of stuff to each other, and I feel real comfortable saying this to your face. I will be damned if you come in a visitor, as good as you think you are, and take my life from me. Ten years, and everybody knows I'm just getting started. I risk my health every single night. You think anybody is gonna remember that effort? Nobody remembers second place. That's why I can't lose. They know I can't lose. That's why I have to win. They know I have to win. That's why they know I have to win this match more than anything in my entire life.
Let The Rock tell you what they know. They know that you've never before had an opponent that you couldn't overcome until The Rock. They know that to me, it's more than just the biggest match of all time. It's more than just you and The Rock making history. They know that The Rock, the people's champion, has come back after all these years to beat you. John, that's what drives me. It drives me. Never before has a man been able to say he's walked into WrestleMania and beat Hulk Hogan, beat Stone Cold Steve Austin, and beat John Cena. On a professional level, The Rock needs to beat you to become the greatest WWE superstar of all time. On a personal level, I just don't like you. And because of that, John, in 6 days, The Rock will tell you to your face, in 6 days, not only is The Rock gonna beat you, but in 6 days, The Rock is gonna give you the ass kicking of a lifetime. You know it, The Rock knows it, and you can bet your ass that they know it too.
I'm gonna put this in terms that you understand. I've seen this movie 1,000 times and I know how it ends. I have made a living off of being the guy you can't see. But on April 1st at WrestleMania, oh, you will see me. You will see me plain as day, Jack. I'll be the guy with my hand raised high, standing over your carcass, and the headline reads what I predicted. John Cena whips The Rock's ass at WrestleMania.
Yeah, but that blow dropped Rock to his knees. Cena still on his feet, barely.
Staggering.
Oh, whoa! Now Rock goes down to an E.
Cena, I think, with just a little more power.
Oh! Cena's still up, but here comes Rock, paying off. Rights after rights after rights. And now laying low.
No!
Attitude adjustment by Cena!
Vintage Rock.
This is the way that he beat Hulk Hogan, the way Rock beat Stone Cold, maybe the way he's going to beat Cena tonight.
The most electrifying moment all of sports entertainment in his team. People's elbow.
And is he going to do it? Is Cena down and out? Two count and Cena kicked out. Cena kicked out.
What?
A Brahma bull perched on the top rope.
Cross body. Cena rolls through. Cena powering, powering. What? He's got the Rock up. John Cena with an unbelievable show of strength.
I can't believe it.
The AA. He got him. Cena got him. Cena got him. Now Rock kick out again.
Tyson, in his prime, was once quoted as saying, in order to be the greatest that ever lived, you have to beat everyone living. I have accomplished every single goal. I have jumped every roadblock in my entire career, except for you. At WrestleMania 29, your time is up. My time is now.
Your time is now. My time is up. No, 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 no. Rock's time is just getting started. You want to quote famous athletes? Well, I got a quote for you. I got a quote for you from a famous athlete, and it goes like this. Winning is about heart. You just got to have it in the right place. The man who said that quote, Lance Armstrong, he was full of crap, and so are you.
Well played, Rock. Unbelievable confidence. That confidence in your eyes, I had that a year ago. Listen, in 34 days, history will not repeat itself. I make history. In 34 days, at WrestleMania 29, I will become the WWE Champion.
You just crystallized everything that is The Rock and John Cena right here. I tell you in front of the world because we're live. John Cena, that's the biggest difference between you and me. You think you can beat me? I know I can beat you. And at WrestleMania 29 in front of the world, I will beat you. Again.
I gotta say, it really pained me last year to watch the two of you. It seemed to me that you both got overtaken with bad blood. And what I wanna know, and what I think wrestling fans all around the world wanna know, the WWE Universe wants to know, what happened? What changed?
I'll tell you what happened. I'll tell you what changed. Two guys went at it last year's WrestleMania, wanting to be the best, the absolute best. There were no cheap shots, there were no screw jobs, just two guys going at it for over 30 minutes. I beat John in the middle of the ring, 1, 2, 3. After that loss, he didn't bitch, he didn't moan, he didn't complain. He took it like a man, and I respect that.
Everyone here on this panel want to know why. Why are you going to beat The Rock at WrestleMania? You want a reason? Here is your reason. I know I am better than The Rock. And much, much more importantly, The Rock knows I am better than The Rock.
The bottom line is this. You want to prove The Rock wrong? Prove The Rock wrong. You want to prove the world wrong? Prove him wrong. Prove him wrong at WrestleMania. But better than that, how about you prove me wrong right now?
Gentlemen.
Rock. John, come on.
Guys. Some deja vu there, but I think John's thinking better of it.
Yeah, last year.
I think you're doing the right
thing. I'm not sure he is, King. Maybe not. I'm sure he is.
Last year when Cena did this, he got caught.
He's really mocking The Rock now, and this is not good.
The Rock was waiting again.
John Cena sucking The Rock in.
Hey,
Cena.
Unbelievable.
Sucking him in.
The Rock has him! The Rock's got it! He's done it twice!
Cena survives!
Tell The Rock he just made it two in a row!
Oh, man!
Watch this!
You're right. Absolutely trying to sucker The Rock in, and I thought he'd done it right there.
Cena learned from his mistakes.
But once again, The Rock able to counter with that rock bottom, but it still didn't get the job done.
These guys are throwing everything at each other. Now it's Cena again with The Rock up high. Rock countered another time. Rock, Cena.
Whoa.
Back and forth we go. No.
Rock is determined that he's going to hit that rock bottom for a win.
And Cena's determined he's going to hit the AA.
DDT! That might be enough right there. That might do it. Cover him.
These guys can't keep getting up.
This is an incredible moment.
John's got a feeling back there. He's got to know it. Nope.
And again, Cena counters. AA! Cover! Cena does it!
Get out of here, John. Go! John Cena.
3-on-1. You got no shot here, Cena.
He's never wanted to back away from a fight. John Cena.
Stupid.
And now the numbers game of the Shield has taken down John Cena. And Cena trying somehow to fight with everything he has. But Reigns and Ambrose and Rollins are mugging Cena.
There's no way that one man is going to fight over these three jackals.
The Shield says they're going to distribute justice where they see injustice. I don't know what the injustice is, but they're meting out their form of justice.
And here comes some help. Sheamus, who's had his issues in the past with the Shield. Cena's been beat down in the corner.
Still
and the Shield
on
turns their attention to the Celtic Warrior, and Sheamus trying to brawl his way out of this.
He's trying to brawl his way out of it, but there's no hope. But it's three of these dogs on one. What can you do?
And Sheamus is being mauled.
Man.
One of those powerful forces I've ever seen coming.
And here comes Ryback.
Look at this. It's still 3-on-1.
But let's not forget.
Sheamus is down. Cena's down.
The Shield has cost Ryback the WWE title on so many different occasions.
There we go.
And there goes Ambrose. And there goes Rollins. And now Ryback and Reigns 1-on-1.
Well, this is the way it should be. But no, no, look at this now.
Yeah, but notice how Reigns was able to move Ryback right back in to the assault. And Ryback laid out on the steps. Sheamus ended out here fighting now. And Sheamus, oh, he hit that post so hard. A wicked collision with a steel post by Sheamus. And these men who almost cost Rock the championship last night by triple powerbombing him through a table. And Cena trying to get himself some more.
But the numbers, they have incredible ability to stay with 3-on-1.
Again, a courageous and brave effort by Cena and Sheamus and Ryback.
But now Cena suffering the second beatdown from the Shield.
It's one of the most powerful and destructive forces I've ever seen coming to WWE.
The Shield isolating all three of these stars. And now it's John Cena.
No, not this again.
About to suffer the fate.
He wanted to stay in front.
Triple powerbomb to Cena.
Should have left when he could. These guys' comments, very simple. Run.
Here comes Cena, the WWE champion. Oh. He's pumped with adrenaline.
Oh, man.
Cena running out of motion. John Cena!
What a tough guy. What a tough champion.
You can't see me. Five knuckle shuffle lands.
Look out, Rollins! Cena rolls through.
That is God-given strength. Wow!
Pure power. Oh, and the leg gave out. And a spear. Cena's Achilles gave out. A spear by Reigns. The legal man. The Shield is right again.
They're still undefeated.
John Cena, Roman Reigns, facing off.
What an incredible moment.
Their eyes on the prize, and here they go. Hammering away at each other. There's no ladder in the ring.
Roman Reigns countered. Reigns with a spear to Cena. A spear to Cena. Cena back to his feet. Reigns caught. Cena caught Reigns. Another AA. Third of the match.
Wow.
Cena rolls through. The power of Cena. Another AA. Cover on Reigns. Hooks the leg. Cena with a. Cena with it, a look of absolute disbelief.
Everyone in Staples Center has the exact same expression. John Cena came to Raw to fight the big dog. And now, the greatest of all time is asking himself, was it worth it?
Wow.
think John Cena's doing a little bit more than that. John Cena's testing himself.
John Cena just glanced over at Roman Reigns. You can see the ball, Superman punch! Reigns caught Cena, spear! Reigns cover!
Got caught sleeping.
Shoulders down!
Roman
Reigns has done it!
Now the whole world can acknowledge me.
Brought me back, it was you. And it was Roman Reigns. So that brings me to the what. What am I here for? The WWE Universal Championship. When? About 5 weeks from now, a little event called SummerSlam. Where? Allegiant Stadium, Las Vegas. That's a pretty safe place to bet. Why? Here's where it gets interesting. I can stand here excited and tell you about the pageantry of SummerSlam, about being a main event in a packed stadium. I could tell you about a history-making, record-breaking 17th championship win. It's not because of any of that. It's because Roman Reigns is an and I believe he needs to be knocked down a peg. This pathetic Roman Reigns experience has gone on long enough. Roman Reigns is an arrogant, self-absorbed, overhyped, overprotected, overexposed gimmick who's not as over as he says he is. And that is coming from me. You know, there's a saying, If you're good, you'll tell everybody. If you're good, you will demand that they acknowledge you, if you're good. Now, Dallas, you remember that team effort I was talking about when you was making all that noise? What'd that sound like? No. Come on, this is your chance to shine. What'd that sound like? I hear this section. I don't so much hear this section. What did that sound like? Hey, Roman, the rest of that saying is if you're great, they tell you. And I'm telling you right now, I'm gonna be at SmackDown on Friday, and I can't wait to see you there.
John Cena acknowledged me at Money in the Bank. John Cena acknowledged me on Monday Night Raw. He acknowledged me tonight. And Paul, to be honest, I wanted to acknowledge John. I really did, yeah. Hollywood fooled me. They put a whole new paint job on John. I thought we were gonna get something new. I thought we were gonna get something special. But what happened at Money in the Bank? What happened? He came out here and he put on a nostalgia act. It's the same thing. He came out here, the same music, the same entrance, the same run to the ring, the same outfit, the same promo, the same insults. If I wanted that, all I had to do was search online for 2005 John Cena. It's the same thing over and over and over. It's like missionary position every single night. Oh. In the tribal chief, the head of the table, we're not interested in that. No. We don't get motivated by that. We don't get inspired by that. So you're right, John. You are right. I can't see you. I don't want to see you. I don't need to see you. I have no desire to see you. And guess what? We're not going to see you. We're not gonna see you in the main event of SummerSlam. Because my answer to your challenge is no. If you sign this contract, I'm gonna smash you and send you right back to NXT. Oh.
Tuesday nights, 8 p.m. He does it. It's all about Paul. That paper's worth a lot of money now.
You think pretty highly of yourself, don't you, Roman? And perhaps justifiably so. But it will be my privilege to return to NXT. Once again, Universal Champion.
Oh, wait a minute! Baron Corbin attacking Balor! And he's tossed the contract out of the ring, and now Balor out of the ring as well!
Whoa.
Baron Corbin hammering away on Finn Balor!
Where did Baron Corbin
He said desperate men do desperate things. And there's John Cena. John Cena. Cena going after Corbin. Corbin setting to the ring post.
Baron Corbin was going to steal the contract?
Was. Cena's got the contract now.
No way. That's a big Sharpie.
Roman Reigns is already signed, and John Cena's now signed to the deal.
That signature is awesome. What does this, mean?
I don't know what it means. Is this even legal?
Can I walk into somebody else's contract negotiation and say, nah, that's mine now? Baron Corbin tried it. Then Cena did it. And Roman's sitting there.
I'm gonna smash you. I'm gonna retain this title. I'm gonna pack you up on a private jet, send you back to the movie set, send you back to Hollywood. But I want you to enjoy this. Tulsa, this might be the last time that we ever get John Cena again. So take us home, kid.
You haven't been embarrassed. You've been protected. This pretty face, those giant bars of soap you got for teeth. You've been protected, Roman. You've been protected by the Shield. Hell, you almost ruined Seth Rollins. You ran Dean Ambrose out of WWE. You've had... You've had 10 whole years, 5 WrestleMania main events, Paul Heyman in your corner, 2 lackeys to do your dirty work, the protection of the system, and it still isn't working. You need to be embarrassed. You people want a compelling story at SummerSlam, right? You people want to be at the edge of your seat, wanting to know what's going to happen. You are right about so much. SummerSlam will be compelling. I will go to a Hollywood movie set, and you will smash me. But he knows better than anybody how much punishment I can take and never quit. I've been against the odds my whole freaking life. I built Suplex City, and all I need to do is just hang in there. And 1, 2, 3, and you're the answer to a trivia question. Who did John Cena beat to become 17-time champion? Wah, wah, wah. You're gonna show up all full of yourself like you normally do and put on a hell of a show. I'm just gonna hang in there for 1, 2, 3. And then I'm gonna take your title. I'm gonna jump the barricade and I'm gonna run out of Allegiant Stadium as fast as I can. I may even blow you a kiss goodbye. This is what you don't get, young man. It's inevitable. No one can protect you anymore. At SummerSlam, the champ is gone. 1, 2, 3. You are protected in this egomaniac bubble, and you need to be brought down to earth. And all that's gonna take is 1, 2, 3. I mean, dude, are you really that naive you couldn't see all the signs? Summer of Cena, that is one hell of a tip-off. A flimsy contract written in fat blue Sharpie? How is that even legal? Dude, I am not here to promote movies. I am here to demote your ass. If you get distracted, 1, 2, 3. You make a mistake, 1, 2, 3. If you're not perfect, it's 1, 2, 3. And at SummerSlam, 1, 2, 3 equals 17. WWE Universe, tomorrow, I will break the all-time championship record. Thanks to Roman Reigns. Tomorrow, SmackDown will no longer have a resident Universal Champion until WrestleMania in Dallas. See you there, thanks to Roman Reigns. Tomorrow, the impossible becomes possible when the champ is here. Thanks to Roman Reigns, and all it takes is 1, 2, 3.
You should have smartened yourself up before you came back, John. Because when people step in the ring with me, I smash them so bad that WWE don't have a use for them anymore, you understand? What puts you above that, huh? What makes you so special? Because you're in Hollywood now, you're a movie guy. You think I can't go to Hollywood, John? You think I can't make movies and commercials and do the whole nine, huh? You think you're better than me? You think I... It's Vegas, right? Let's raise the stakes. Either I'm leaving that stadium as the Universal Champion, or I'm leaving WWE.
What? Kicked out of 2.5, I think, for point taken.
Enough of the talking. The time to fight is now.
From movie set to Allegiant Stadium. Big match, John going high risk.
Cena with Reigns up on his shoulders. John Cena from the second rope. Reigns up high. Cena. For the title, for the 17th time in his career, and Roman Reigns kicks out again. Are you kidding me? This entire stadium thought Cena was winning. The battled, hardened warrior, John Cena. The dominant champion Reigns.
Cena said you need to be embarrassed.
And this time it's Reigns beating Cena with a kick. And John Cena with a right. And Reigns battling back with a right of his own. And now exchanging blows, center of the ring.
Old school. Throwing hands at each other.
But it's John Cena now with the upper hand momentarily.
Until the uppercut.
Superman punch again. Cena still on his feet. Roman Reigns drops Cena this time right on the chin.
I am WWE.
I am WWE, the head of the table, eyeing victory.
Cena up to his feet. Roman Reigns with a spear. And just like that, Roman Reigns will retain the championship.
We got a KO problem. He's a problem, Sammy. He won't leave you alone. He won't stop stalking you. He won't keep dragging you down. And if he's a problem for you, he's a problem for me. If he's a problem for me, he's a problem for the bloodline. But don't worry, the tribal chief has got a solution. Because Sammy, you and I, we're gonna team up. And we're gonna have a tag match against KO. And he can find anybody he wants, but it doesn't matter because we're gonna smash him. We're gonna smash him, we're gonna get rid of him, and we ain't ever gonna see Kevin Owens again.
No, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. Even after all this time, he continues to drag me down. He's a cancer. He betrays everyone in his life. I mean, for crying out loud, I'm his only friend.
Hang on. I misspoke. I was his only friend. I was his only friend, okay? Listen, it'll be an honor and a privilege to stand side by side with you and team up and take him out, and it'll be easy because he's got no one.
I bet you're a little surprised to see me. Had to do it. Well, it's the holiday season, and everybody loves a good holiday surprise, including this guy. And boy, was I surprised when I got a text message out of the blue from my longtime friend, Kevin Owens. He said, "Sup, Peacemaker?" Merman emoji, peace sign emoji, Kev. And then he said, "Did you know you've had a WWE match every year for the past 20 years, except this one? Your streak's about to be broken." Mind blown emoji, eggplant emoji, Santa Claus emoji, peach emoji. "Do you want to be my tag team partner on SmackDown December 30th in Tampa, Florida?" So let me get this straight. I haven't had a match in 2022 and we are running out of chances. And you're asking me that on the last SmackDown of the year, December 30th, if I want to partner with Kevin Owens against the Usiest Sami Zayn and the Tribal Chief, the undisputed WWE Universal Champion Roman Reigns in a main event match that can't be missed? Hell yes, I'll be there! Hell yes, I will be your partner! And hell yes, we will bring the fight to the Bloodline in the final SmackDown of 2022. Make your list, check it twice. The Bloodline's been naughty, and won't it be nice when Santa Claus is coming to town? Ho, ho, holy shit!
Dragging Zayn to the corner, which allows Roman to make the legal tag.
So smart by Roman Reigns. We have got a jam-packed arena wanting to see the greatest hits of John Cena. Well, the Bloodline don't give a damn what the people want.
Yeah, because it's all about Roman Reigns, as it has been for 852 days. Locked and loaded, went for the Superman punch. Kevin Owens caught him with a super kick. And now KO gonna climb up high, up to the top rope. Kevin Owens, frog splash to the champ. He's gonna pin Reigns, he's gonna pin Reigns, and Roman kept it 2.5.
You don't stay the champ that long by going down easy, Cole. You wanna take it from Reigns, you're gonna be a damn sight better than that.
Roman Reigns hasn't been pinned since December of 2019. That would have been incredible for Owens. Oh, a Superman punch! As Owens went for the pop-up powerbomb. Reigns ready to go. Oh, went for the spear! Shoulder first into the post! Kevin Owens has a chance. John Cena pulling himself up to the apron.
This is one of those momentum moments, Cole.
Roman trying to make it to Sammy. Cena begging for Owens. Tag to Zayn, and here comes the GOAT! John Cena, shoulder tackle! And another one by Cena! Down goes Sammy! Drawing Roman Reigns into the ring. Cena now, planted Roman Reigns.
There is just no stopping Cena when he's in this kind of flow.
Tag to Kevin Owens.
table. Five knuckle shuffle.
Get him!
Owens with Reigns. The AA. Attitude adjustment to the champ.
This is going downhill in
Stutter.
A hurry.
Stutter to Sammy. Cover by Owens. KRC to win.
And these people came to see me, a top star, Jimmy Uso. They did not just come to see me, Uso. They came to hear why, Jim, why? And the answer is very simple. I will save my brother 10 times over if I got to, Uso. You see, listen, I don't care if each and every one of you sitting in these damn seats disagree what I've done. I'm telling you, I did it because I love my brother. See, here's the funny thing. The funny thing is, I didn't want Jey Uso to be corrupted like Roman Reigns, and I damn sure didn't want Jey Uso to be corrupted like John Cena. Yeah, let's talk to him. Yeah, let's talk to him. I mean, look at you, dog. This right here, this. You are this place, Uso. This is you. Here's the.
I admit I have an identifiable fashion sense. That's. Never give up on it, you know?
Nah, you ain't about to take this one, brother. You a goat. But you standing in the ring with one of the best now, Uso. See, this is my ring. And here's the funny thing that I wanted to tell you, brother. You and Roman Reigns are exactly alike. Y'all exactly alike, man. Why? How is John Cena like a Roman Reigns? The answer is very damn simple. You take, and take. The only difference is between you and Roman Reigns is you do yours with a smile.
I've been wanting to say this to you for 3 years because I've only been thinking of one thing. The wrong Uso quit. Take that.
Uh-oh. Oh, look out! Cena! Cena! AA! Attitude adjustment! And with that, John Cena is back!
Nobody wants you here, John. Nobody. I told you 2 weeks ago, everybody came to see me, Jim Uso! Yeah. So. Yeah, they love you. They love you here. Well, check this out, Uso. I came out here to tell you to your face. You try to embarrass me again like you did 2 weeks ago. Do it, John. If you ain't gonna do nothing, get the hell up out my ring.
Uh-oh. Wait just a second. The enforcer, Solo Sikoa. And you heard what Solo had to say earlier tonight. Sikoa saying, I know what I need to do. I finished this tonight. Solo marching with purpose toward the ring.
Oh!
just hammered away on Cena and Jimmy Uso as well.
Wait a second. It's AJ Styles.
The phenomenal one looking to even the numbers.
And even the score with Jimmy Uso. And here comes Cena.
Kick from Styles rocks Uso.
And the five knuckle shuffle. And you hear Heyman yelling, save Jimmy, save Jimmy. And Solo Sikoa does just that.